Hello. The answer to how is the current situation of vegetarianism in Turkey, or how many vegetarians are there in Turkey, is really very difficult to answer, exactly like in the USA or any other country in the world. The best way is to relate it to different pieces of information and thus to interpret the answer. At least once a week, it is possible to find a reported article in newspapers about vegetarianism, or to see a famous singer like Harun Kolçak, Leman Sam or Füsun Önal, or doctors like Ender Saraç talking about health and the economic benefits of vegetarianism over the last 10 years. The Turkish Member of Parliament of German origin, Cem Özdemir, from Germany Greens Party, is also famous as a very meticulous and keen vegetarian in Turkey. No poll or survey has been conducted till now about the situation of vegetarianism. The famous and historical Turkish cuisine is offering a vast opportunity of items, particularly for lacto-vegetarians, as well as the acceptance of dry beans and rice, chickpeas or lentils or peas, and bulgur, cracked wheat. Widely known yogurt is a word which has entered Western languages from Turkish. Since it is the oldest food of nomadic Turkish tribes, brought from Middle Asian steppes, having many derivatives like ayran, yogurt drink, cacık, appetizer, kurut, dried yogurt, süzme, dense yogurt. Another trend nowadays is preference of white meat or soy products like textured soy protein, tofu and soy meat to red meat. By the way, if you are interested in soy meat, you can watch my video showing to make soy meat machine as a hobby in YouTube in your free times. There are about 2.5 million diabetics, 1.5 million with high cholesterol level people, and 20,000 people suffering from cancer in Turkey, and these foods are a better choice for them. Although you can see McDonald's or Burger King or Döner Kebab shop on every corner of Istanbul, there are also about 10-15 restaurants identifying themselves as vegetarian restaurants, except 20 or 30 Far Eastern restaurants. Nevertheless, as mentioned before, in local restaurants you can generally find tasty alternatives for veggies. Once a year, Turks sacrifice a ram in memory of Prophet Abraham, but Islam advises less consumption of meat, saying too much meat consumption is a kind of addiction, like alcoholic drinks. The prominent Islam scholar Abdülkadir Geylani would once a year have a vegan diet for 40 days, and if we examine Islam and Prophet Muhammad's sayings, we see that he advises us to eat meat at least once in 40 days. Otherwise, our nature will be harmed, and when we examine the contemporary medicine, we see that the best source of vitamin B12 and iron is red meat. It is really very obvious that our body will have no harm if we eat meat once or twice in 40 days. On the contrary, this is the exact way of nutrition of thousands of centenarians in Turkey, Caucasia, Balkans. Zara Aga, who lived 160 years, also applied this diet. These people eat meat very rarely, as advised by Islam, and their basic protein source is yogurt. On the other hand, if we examine the life of George Bernard Shaw, who is known to be the longest living vegan, we can see that he had pernicious anemia in most of his life of 92 years. In Islam, human is the most honored creature, most important creature, like in all other religions, and all other things were simply created to serve him. However, there is also an old region of Istanbul called Etkemez, non-eater of meat, because a mystic Sufi sect abstained from meat, just a small sect. Between 1952 and 1972, three big vegetarian societies were founded nationwide by famous professors, doctors, politicians, artists and intellectuals, and now we have a magazine named Buğday. I think that the people of our world hopefully will find the right path to the century's biggest fact of overlooked vegetarians tend to live longer and to suffer less from chronic disabling conditions than their meat-eating peers, as stated in the most important medicine book of the world, the Merck Manual, 15th edition, Page 9. Bless you guys.